And I'm often jealous of your life, but particularly so this time, because you got to spend time with 80s pop sensation Belinda Carlisle, who I love. I'm just about to finish her book. She's amazing.
Yeah, her book is called Lips Unsealed, and I do recommend anyone has a reel. It's one of those great rock autobiographies. It's, of course, called Lips Unsealed from the famous Go-Go's hit Our Lips Are Sealed. Mm. But not everyone heard the words that way. Do you know it's one of the most famous Mondegreens where the lyrics are misheard?
What do people hear it as?
A lot of people thought it was Alex the Seal. Alex the Seal. That and many other things I discussed with Belinda Carlisle yesterday.
All the kids were in a band except for a few of us girls. So we were sitting on a curb one night at a party and thought, let's form a band. Okay, what do you want to do? I had the choice of playing drums or singing, so I chose to sing, and that's how we started. We had no idea how to do anything. All our songs with masking tape on the frets instead of notes, and took lessons and worked really hard, and it just happened to be natural talent. Look at the clip for Our Lips Are Sealed. You look so happy. But at the time, you didn't think you were thin enough. Right. The press made such a big deal because I wasn't your stereotypical star. You know, I wasn't skinny and it went up and down on my weight. Always pretty plump, cute, chubby. And that kind of thing, I'm sorry, even if they say you're thin, it's not good. It did a lot of psychological damage. Nobody's kiss moves me aside, and I have no place left to hide. Tell me, what can I do? I have a vision of you. Well, how did it manifest itself? Well, you know, I found that if I took lots of drugs, I could get skinny. And I mean, I looked like hell, but I still was thin. There was so much success with Heaven and looking a certain way and photographing a certain way that there was pressure on me to be all these things, which naturally I'm just not. It's just weird because you're expected to be something that's really pretty much impossible. Suddenly I'm in too
deep to ever get out. 30 years you were addicted to cocaine.
Mm-hmm.
How did you finally get the strength to overcome it?
Well, for me it was a matter of life and death, and that's what it came down to.
Is it true that John Belushi lectured you on your drug use?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, we were out and, you know, I had a minuscule amount of drugs and asked if he wanted some, and he just laid into me a huge lecture on the evils of drugs and how people were gonna start, you know, give them to me when I was rich and famous and, you know, yeah.
Our Lips Are Sealed is one of the most famous misheard lyrics. So there's a bunch of people on the planet who to this day think you're singing
Alex the Seal. I know, that's weird. Do I really say
Alex the Seal? When did you become aware of that? And is it mostly in Australia that
here in Sydney is when I became aware of it. I was at some radio station near the bridge. And I was like, what? Yeah, people still make reference to that. It's funny. I mean, I don't think sounds like I say that, but a lot of people do.
Belinda Carlisle's national tour begins tomorrow night at the Rudy Hill RSL, and she's still fantastic. I just reckon she's one of the greats.
Will she be singing Alex the Seal?
She will be singing Alex the Seal, and best we all sing along.